In this video, I'm going to talk about the current integration capabilities between SAS and Amazon Redshift. The current versions of SAS at the time I'm speaking are SAS 9.4M6 and SAS Viya 3.5. SAS provides many ways to work with Amazon Redshift. If we use SAS 9.4 or a SAS compute server in SAS Viya, or SAS Cloud Analytic Services, also known as CAS in SAS Viya, we will be able to work with Redshift data. During this presentation, we will cover the following scenarios. 1. Loading data from SAS to Redshift. 2. Processing Redshift data in place from SAS. 3. Extracting data from Redshift to SAS. 4. Loading data from Redshift to CAS. 5. Processing Redshift data in place from CAS. And 6. Saving CAS data to Redshift. Let's start by scenario number 1, loading data in Redshift from SAS, with a focus on bulk loading. Redshift inserts are slow. Based on that observation, using bulk loading techniques to load data into Redshift is mandatory if we want to have acceptable performance. Instead of a standard load using SQL inserts, we will choose to run a bulk load. Behind the scenes, a bulk load exports the SAS data as flat files, copy them to an S3 bucket, and run a Redshift copy statement. This is lightning fast in comparison with Redshift inserts. How to use bulk load from SAS? Simply add bulk load equals yes and BL bucket equals the S3 bucket and path we want to use as a staging area. In order to work, the bulk load process requires the AWS keys to be properly set up on the SAS server. Bulk loading can load a 15 million records SAS dataset into Redshift in 90 seconds, instead of 16 minutes with an optimized SQL inserts method. Scenario number 2, processing Redshift data in place from SAS. This is about pushing the processing to where the data is. SAS provides multiple ways to achieve this. It has the advantages of leveraging the compute infrastructure of Redshift and minimizing data movement between SAS and Redshift. So we have implicit pass-through with proc SQL or proc fed SQL, where SAS will convert a SAS SQL proprietary syntax into a Redshift SQL syntax and send it to Redshift for processing. The result will be sent back to SAS. SAS is not or little used for the processing of the query. This allows users to keep using SAS SQL syntax or tools generating SAS SQL syntax, like SAS Enterprise Guide, while leveraging the power of their Redshift instance transparently. Then we have explicit pass-through, where users can write and send a customized and optimized SQL string to Redshift. This is about writing Redshift SQL query syntax and orchestrating it from SAS. Finally, we have some in-database procedures. It is SAS command procedures that are converted into optimized Redshift SQL queries and are executed in Redshift. Only the result set, expected to be small, is sent back to SAS for further processing. Freak, tabulate, summary are examples of SAS procedures that can be pushed to Redshift transparently. Scenario number 3, extracting Redshift data to SAS. Again, multiple possibilities. The best is to use bulk unload to stage the Redshift data in S3 using the Redshift unload statement before moving the resulting flat files into SAS. Just add the bulk unload and BL bucket options to your extraction process. Scenario number 4. We have switched to SAS Viya and want to load Redshift data into Cloud Analytic Services or CAS. By default, when we load a Redshift table in a massively parallel processing CAS environment, the table is downloaded on the CAS controller before being distributed over the CAS workers. You can see an example of a CASLib statement to define a Redshift CASLib and a podcast util to load a Redshift table into CAS. We can improve the loading by activating a multi-node process. In this case, each CAS worker will send a specific query and get a portion of the Redshift table back in CAS. This helps to parallelize the loading of the Redshift table. To activate multi-node, we set the non-read nodes options to 0, meaning use as many workers as possible, or to the exact number of workers we want to use, like in this example with 3. We can go further and use a bulk unload technique to speed up the loading phase. Instead of using SQL to extract the data, the Redshift table is staged on S3 before being pushed on each CAS worker. In addition to the non-read nodes option, some bulk unload options are to be set either in the CASLib statement or in the CASUtil procedure. AWS config and credential files option manage where to find the appropriate AWS keys to access S3. Scenario number 5, processing Redshift data in place from CAS. SAS Viya is a data crunching platform, and CAS, its analytic and in-memory engine, needs data before users can leverage it using CAS actions. So there isn't much to do in this space. However, CAS provides some capabilities to delegate some of the work required when loading a table into CAS. For example, we can use FetchSQL implicit pass-through to offload a SQL statement to Redshift before getting the data back in CAS. This allows to run complex SQL queries in Redshift and only get the results loaded in CAS, instead of loading the whole source tables and running the complex SQL query in CAS. An explicit pass-through version also exists if we know exactly how to write a complex Redshift SQL query. Scenario number 6, saving CAS data to Redshift. The default saving mechanism will make users unhappy and is not recommended because Redshift inserts are slow as mentioned previously. CAS data is gathered on the CAS controller before being uploaded in Redshift using SQL inserts. Here is the SAS code without any specific option. We can improve a little bit the writing to Redshift phase by enabling multi-node. In this case, each CAS worker writes its portion of data directly to Redshift. But this still relies on SQL inserts. To activate multi-node, use the non-write nodes option. What we really want to do is to use bulk loading techniques in this case. And there are two variants. The first variant is to trigger the bulk load from the CAS controller using this code. The second variant is to trigger the bulk load process from the CAS workers. It is about using bulk load alongside multi-node saving. From a code perspective, it is the combination of bulk load options with the non-write nodes option. The last two variants are the fastest ways to save data from CAS to Redshift. If you want to go further with this topic, don't hesitate to check out my SAS Global Forum paper, SAS and Amazon Redshift Overview of Current Capabilities, available at the following address.